Americans will soon be learning more about the House Democrats' impeachment inquiry into President Trump. Lawmakers are starting to release the first set of transcripts. Two key transcripts were released today, one by the former ambassador to Ukraine, Marie Yovanovitch, and Michael McKinley, former senior advisor to Secretary of State Mike Pompeo. Transcripts for the depositions of several other witnesses are expected to be released in the coming days. Joining me now to take a look at the next phase of the impeachment inquiry is Vince Coglianese, editorial director at The Daily Caller and co-host of Mornings on the Mall at WMAL Radio. Vince, welcome back to the program.
Thank you.
Republicans have made a lot of this closed-door nature of the impeachment inquiry so far. So how do you think today's transcripts will help to sort of release, have the effect on that? I mean, does it provide transparency and can help sort of solve this problem?
Yeah, it's baby steps. This is the first small effort of transparency of things that have already happened. Look, Adam Schiff, who is the Democrat who runs the House Intelligence Committee, he's running all of this. Nancy Pelosi's empowered him, and he has made no secret of the fact that he does want to take down the President of the United States. And in several opportunities where he's spoken to the public, he's actually lied about the specifics of the president's conversation. For instance, he made up an entire phone conversation the president had with the head of Ukraine. He did that in a public hearing. He later came out and said, I'm sorry, that was supposed to be a parody. He lied about being in contact with the whistleblower prior to all of this. He eventually came out and said, well, actually, yeah, my committee staff was in touch with him. I should have been more clear about that. Over time, of course, he's said that he had evidence of collusion between Trump and Russia that we have never seen. So he's made a whole bunch of statements like this, and it's led the White House to be really upset with him and the way he's conducted this process, specifically in secret. So these are the baby steps of getting some of this information out in front of the public.
If the inquiry moves to a House Judiciary Committee, President Trump's lawyers will be able to cross-examine those witnesses and present really a formal defense in all of this. How significant, if that happens, will it be?
Well, it'll be pretty significant for the president to get a word in edgewise in a process that has been really all incoming and no return fire. So, yeah, that'll be a big deal for the president to be able to mount a defense. Also, it'll be a big deal if we actually start to get some of these hearings in public, because then you'll actually get to see the witnesses mixing it up with both Democrats and Republicans. And it'll give the American public a more holistic view of whether or not this is a legitimate attempt to go after the president of the United States or an illegitimate one in service of politics ahead of 2020.
In the meantime, White House officials are refusing congressional subpoenas to testify is another big issue. Is that an effective strategy, or does this sort of play into the hands of those who alleged obstruction of justice?
The president's critics will never run out of things to criticize him for. So I don't think you should measure any decision whether or not President Trump will be criticized. The answer to that is yes, he will be criticized. He'll always be criticized. I think as a political matter, the White House is playing this correctly, which is fight like crazy. Every opportunity you have, don't cede territory, because if you cede territory, it will be used against you as a cudgel. So that's why I think you see the White House resisting as much as they can, offering witnesses or testimony or anything, because they see this as a deeply unfair process and they don't want to legitimize it by beginning to turn people over.
Really quickly, you mentioned the 2020 elections. Right now, we've been so focused on the impeachment inquiry. There's so many other issues that haven't necessarily been brought to the forefront. Do you think that Republicans and Democrats are missing an opportunity to talk about other issues right now ahead of 2020?
This is the Washington way. Washington's always missing the point of what the United States is talking about. It turns out impeachment is a conversation that's very much happening in Washington and not so much happening across the rest of the country, not as much for certain. And so the big topics like health care and jobs and the economy and what the future holds, and if you're going to be better off 4 years from now than you are today, those are the types of things that these candidates should be talking about, but they're not, because they're so consumed with trying to throw Trump out of office before they even run against him.
Okay, we may get a clue tomorrow in some of these states at least. Vince Coglianese, editorial director at The Daily Caller. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.